another opportunity to live my best life. I'm above ground. I'm living. I'm breathing. I'm moving. I can think. As the old folks say, I have the activity of my limbs. I am super, super duper excited to be on another episode of Live Your Best Life. And so I am super excited. I'm going to jump right in, because I have a phenomenal guest with me today, one that I have met, but now I am grown to love. She is my sister. And good morning, good morning, good morning. Hello to everybody. So I want to present to my listening audience, if you're watching it on the replay, if you see it in YouTube, if you see it in JuliaRoyston.net, later on, I'm pleased to introduce to some and present to others Dr. Tamara Bowles, who is going to introduce herself and tell us who she is, where she lives, her website, and where you can find her on social media. Now, I want you to make sure that you're following Dr. Bowles as well as checking out her website, so you can support her. Dr. Bowles, take it away.
Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Tamara Bowles. My website is byfconsulting.org. I just transitioned less than a year ago from Louisville, Kentucky. Hello to all my supporters in Louisville. I now live in Charlotte, North Carolina.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. So where can everybody find you on social media?
You can find me on social media, Dr. Tamara Bowles, FaceTime, or via LinkedIn, Dr. Tamara Bowles.
Wonderful, wonderful. So, you know, most of the time when people are watching these broadcasts, they're going to social media at the same time and actually finding people and connecting with them. So I want you to tell us about your BYF consulting business, because that is extremely important given the season that we're in, for us to get all the tools, information, and resources that we can. Now, I know we were on the educational summit on in August of 2020, but I still want those of you who are joining us today to know about BYF Consulting, what it does, and how you help people literally around the world.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Royston. My company, BYF Consulting LLC, which is my passion, specializes in standardized test prep such as ACT, SAT, PSAT. I just picked up GRE as well as GMAT. Also life coaching, public speaking, and speaking engagements. My ultimate responsibility is to make sure that I prepare scholars, young adults, for the tools, resources, and materials necessary for them to be successful on standardized testing. I also tutor K through 12, all academic course subjects.
Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. Okay, so go ahead and blow up her website and blow it her inbox on Facebook and LinkedIn, because right now, most of us are educators, and most of the parents sending their children back to school, it looks different. And so it is different, and it does look different. And everybody, we do not have enough time today to even talk about all the different scenarios. But as you well know, it is going to be a combination of either in person, if we can, given the health situation, given the pandemic, given the numbers. Are we going to be in person? Are we going to be in virtual? And so I really want you to address the children who struggle with in-person instruction. How is that going to be different for them in the virtual space?
Okay. I know that during this pandemic, Dr. Royston and everyone who is listening, that we are going through a shift. However, I want you to know that there are resources out there, such as BYF Consulting, that can assist your child or children or grandchildren in making sure that they are continuing to learn. So what I do is I tailor all of my sessions to that child or children's learning style. So on that note, I ask that you reach out to me on byfconsulting.org and let's brainstorm, let's have a conversation and go to the next level.
Exactly. Because we cannot be left behind. You know, we had the No Child Left Behind initiative, which was great in name. It was great in word, and we made some major strides in the No Child Left Behind, but it's a real place now. It is something that we really have to consider, understand, and know. And so that Dr. Bowles and BYF Consulting covers that from kind of start to finish. So we're doing all academic or areas, math, science, social studies, everything, English, reading, writing. We're covering all the areas. So that is a viable resource. So yes, it is a fee, but it is a viable resource because long-term, you do not want your child to be left behind, left out. As much as the teachers are striving, they're in the learning curve of the virtual learning space. And it doesn't matter whether your child was in person, because I'm a retired teacher myself, in person or in virtual space, you've got to understand where your child's learning is. You got to understand what their cognitive ability is, and you got to be honest about it. You know, I had a sister who was an excellent writer, but she hated math. She struggled in math. My thing was geometry, and I had an issue with that. I mean, you know, we all have to be honest and really seriously honest about where your child is and what your child's needs are. Correct?
Correct. Absolutely. So
is there an assessment that's done when they reach out to you, not just a conversation, but is there a full assessment that's done as well?
Dr. Royston, there is an assessment that I use to gauge and identify their strengths and weaknesses. Based on the assessment results, I tailor their specific reading, English, math, whatever subject that I'm going to tutor them in, based on that information.
Okay.
And then we continue to move to progress.
Excellent. So byfconsulting.org, schedule a time, schedule an appointment, be on the lookout, inbox her on Facebook, inbox her on LinkedIn. That's what this is about. Not only just her business, but we're striving to make sure that the next generation is prepared for what's next. Now, preparation is very fluid in what I say, because we've got to almost be expecting the unexpected. We don't quite know what to expect of coming up next. So I want to ask before, because you know I got to get to my favorite part, the book. But just one more question in regards to business itself. Do you have any advice for the business owner, not just for tutoring and education, because you've done all of that, an educator and a businesswoman, but as a businesswoman, what is one tip? Because we know that you're a consultant and we want people to reach out to you, but what is one tip that you would give an aspiring or even someone who's even struggling in the business arena to really keep going and to stay afloat?
Yes, one tip of advice that I would like to share with you if you are interested in becoming an entrepreneur or starting your own business is to have a plan. Make sure you have that vision board as well as a support team. Once you have all those key components, then move on to your business plan and just go from there.
Exactly. We got to have as to say, work our plan and plan our work. And you know, you definitely, and it does take a village to raise a child, but it's going to take a village to grow. It's going to take a team to grow a business as well. I outsource a lot, but I have a team that I consult with. You cannot be on the island. You've got to find a coach, a mentor, someone who, now Dr. Bowles is what we call a firecracker. She doesn't play around. Okay. So when, you know, she's 20 minutes early and may stay 20 minutes late, that's her work ethic. And so some of you who may have great business ideas, you may have to work on, this is my tip for you, you're going to have to work on discipline yourself to sit down and make sure that you're getting the advice from people who are experienced in business so that you don't make unnecessary mistakes. Now, there's always going to be mistakes made. I mean, that's irregardless. But if at least you get the plan, at least if you get the people, and then if you have people surrounding you and people that are going to give you great advice so that you can move forward in your business, it will make it all the better, all the better. So super excited. Congratulations and all that you're doing in business. And again, go to byfconsulting.org as well as find her on Facebook and LinkedIn so that you can follow her on everything she's doing. Now, Dr. Bowles is on the Bowles, so don't play. And Tamara is T-A-M-A-R-A. I've seen it all different kinds of ways spelling. And Bowles is B-O-W-L-E-S, just in case you're asking, just in case you're curious. Okay, I want to switch gears before we run out of time to one of my favorite parts because I'm an author and a publisher. So my favorite thing, of course, is talking about their book. So introduce your book to us. Tell us what it's about and how people can purchase it.
Thank you. The name of my first book is Cleaning Out My Garden. And I do have a picture of this cleaning out my garden. Of course, I tab it because I'm always constantly reading it. And that book will bless you. It is for all audience, all ages.
And so, you know, one of the things that, and I'm privileged to publish that book, Cleaning Out My Garden. So I want you, it is going to bless you. It is going to encourage you. And we're not going to give away, you know, it's not going to be spoiler alert. We're not going to give away all the nuggets, but cleaning out my garden, why do you think, well, first off, why did you write it? And then secondly, what are one important key components to keeping that garden clean?
Cleaning out my garden is just what it says. It's my life. It tells my story, my testimony, and how I had a praying Aunt Kathleen who helped me to achieve goals, to help me see things that I didn't see and helped me to keep blinders on. And because of cleaning out my garden, that is the reason why, one of the reasons at least, that I am who I am today. And when you clean out that garden and replenish things and create things and move things around, you're looking at something that you thought didn't have potential that has potential.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, so everybody's going to have to take an introspective look. You've got to make sure that you are being strategic about your life. It's something that personally I do on a monthly basis, sometimes on a daily basis. Look at where I am, where I'm going. And I really, this is my tip to you. In addition to purchasing Dr. Bowles' book, Cleaning Out My Garden, which you can purchase on her website, byfconsulting.org, which will enable you to get a signed copy, as well as get on her list to know what else she's coming up with. But also, you should do this periodically. There should be a time in your life where you stop and review the good, the bad, the ugly, the disappointing, sometimes the sad. Because we're molded and made, we're able to live our best life because we stopped, we took a breather, we reviewed, we evaluated, and then we made changes. Now that change is often seen as a curse word, but change has to happen before growth, okay? Cleaning out your garden is weeding, is pruning, is putting that nasty fertilizer on, all of that stuff that has to happen. But it has to happen so that you can live a fruitful and productive life. So I highly recommend Cleaning Out My Garden by Dr. Tamara Bowles, that you purchase that at byfconsulting.org. Okay, so I have a question from Facebook. First off, there's all kinds of recommendations. Be sure and go to Julia Royston timeline because there's all types of recommendations. There are almost 20 comments about Dr. Bowles being a wonderful educator, all the tools that she's come up. She tutored my child. So if you need references or referrals, they're all in the comments, all up and down the timeline. And so I'm super excited for that. I knew that before then, but there's nothing like a testimonial. But I did have one question. What someone asked, what is a tip that you have for a kindergartner, for somebody starting out learning online early on, the little ones? Because that has all that has been kind of my prayer and everything too as well in regards to the little ones who may not have been to daycare, who may just have been home with your mom and now thinking they're going to put a backpack on and leave the house and go to school, they are at home. What advice do you have for that parent?
For the individual that asked that question, I want to share three different tips of advice. Number one, have a conversation with your son or daughter at an early age because their brain is like a sponge at that time. So they're absorbing things. So my recommendation, number one, is to show them videos to model things kinesthetically as well as hands-on, to show them and let them listen to alphabet songs, play memory cards. Engagement is crucial because they are so young. So once you introduce them to terminology, to facts as it relates to colors, to letters and things like that, they will be familiar with those things and then kind of build upon that. And I would love for you to reach out to me because I would like to share some experiences that I have took on thus far as it relates to those kindergartens and helping them to be acclimated when they start school as it relates to first grade, second grade, and on up.
Perfect. Perfect. Okay. BYFconsulting.org. It is in the description of this program and broadcast today. So be sure. And I wanted to make sure that you didn't miss it and that you had it. So it is in the description. BYFconsulting.org. Just click there and go right in. I want to thank those that have been in the Zoom room with us today as well, with tons of comments and congratulations and thank you for Dr. Bowles' services. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. Why not you? Why not your next? That's the reason why you need to make your appointment, schedule your time with Dr. Bowles so you can help your child. I also recommend educators. If you need some advice, I know she provides consultation for educators as well. So that, and of course, if you now were in the Zoom space, you can have Dr. Bowles as your speaker. She can do a PD, professional development, with your school on faculty meeting. Just make that arrangement. And she can do that virtually from the comfort of her own home and office. So, you know, that's one of the beauties of this whole virtual digital space. I know it's hard. It's been a major transition for a lot of people. But me, it's a wider reach. Me and Dr. Bowles can talk all day and every day. You know, we would love to be eating, as they say, some soul food somewhere at that wonderful restaurant in Charlotte that she took me and my husband to. And we would love to be doing that. But in the meantime, we're still connected. You know, we may be afar, we may be separated by distance, but we're still connected. So I really, really strive to encourage you to do that today. So I've got one last question. Dr. Bowles, I want you to tell this audience, how do you live your best life? Just one thing. Or an encouraging part one, either how do you live your best life or how you encourage other people to live their best life?
I live my best life one day at a time because I want you to know greatness is inside of you, but you must clean out your garden. You have got to remove those emotional hedges of hurt that are hiding from your from you living your best life. You have to create a social system of pest control to keep people and avoid situations that will do harm to you. And you have to replenish your soil. And one final note, you have to make sure that with the emotional, mental, and social nutrients that you need to grow, you need the plants of prosperity, the fruits of focus, and vegetable of victory. And I'm going to leave it at that.
Yes. I love it. I love it. The vegetables of victory. Come on through. We're going to produce some vegetables of victory. We're going to produce some wonderful, wonderful, wonderful things. Thank you so much. Reverend James, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sweetie. I really appreciate that. Thank you for all the excellent comments. Thank you so much for everyone joining us today. I know that we have many activities on this day, every day. You can be in multiple Zoom rooms, and some people I know are tired of the Zoom rooms, but I'm always grateful and appreciative for anyone who joins us either in the Zoom room or live on Facebook or live on YouTube. So reach out to us, stay connected to us, continue to follow us here on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, Julia Royston. I'm everywhere you want to be. Also be sure and follow Dr. Tamara Bowles on Facebook and LinkedIn and check her out and be sure and schedule your appointment at byfconsulting.org. I am Dr. Julia Royston, pleased as punch to have been on with you Facebook Live this morning. Coming up next at 10 a.m., move on over to envision-radio.com, envision-radio.com, where my internet radio version of Live Your Best Life is with Miss Stephanie Collins, who is a young entrepreneur, millennial entrepreneur, which I'm super excited to introduce you to at envision-radio. That's envision-radio.com. And then stay tuned all day long. Wonderful gospel music. But at 11 a.m., the Emmy Award winner, actress, comedian, author, and businesswoman, Miss Cheryl Underwood, will be on with her spiritual nourishment. So envision-radio, let that be for the rest of your day and the rest of your week that you enjoy it there. So thank you so much for Dr. Bowles being on with us. Reach out to her at byfconsulting.org. And just in case you're ready to write your book, let's have a conversation at talkwithroyston.com. I'm Dr. Julia Royston, praying, wishing, hoping, and believing God for you today, tomorrow, and always. Live your best life. Have a great day.
Live each and every day. Love and live your way. Do your very best. Learn and lead today. Be the best you can. It's your life. Take a stand. So live. Dr. Julia Royston.